Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss a projectile motion question which is asked by a student. Let's read the question. A cricket ball is thrown at a speed of 56 meter per second in a direction making an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal. Calculate maximum height and time of the flight. So here is the cricket ball. When it is thrown at 30 degree, this vector is the velocity vector, initial velocity vector or starting velocity vector, which is u, and the value of velocity vector is 56 meter per second. Ball is projected at 30 degree, so it will acquire or go in a projectile path like this. At the top of this path, height of the ball will be the maximum height, this height. Now how will we find this maximum height? So for that, first of all we need to break this velocity vector into horizontal component ux and also the vertical component uy. So horizontal means like this, this vector is horizontal vector, this one is the vertical velocity vector. So we need to use the formula u cos theta for horizontal velocity vector and u sin theta for vertical velocity vector. Plug in values 56 cos 30 and 56 sin 30. Once you calculate these values, you will get ux equals 48.5 meter per second, uy equals 28 meter per second. After this, we are going to use the concept that at the top of the path, the vertical velocity vector, that is Vy, because V is the final velocity, so Vy would goes to 0, and the horizontal velocity vector, that is Vx, would remain constant. Constant means whatever is the Ux at this point, at all points of the path, this Ux would remain constant. So Vx would exactly equal to Ux because the horizontal vector is not changing at this point. So it will remain the same 48.5 meter per second at all the points of the path. Right now we don't need this vector, so I'm not writing anything here. It is constant. So we are going to use only vertical velocity vector to find the maximum height. You might ask why? Because height is a vertical distance, right? dy. This is the vertical distance. To find the vertical distance, we need to use only vertical velocities. Whenever we are finding range, which is also called as dx or horizontal distance, we use horizontal velocity vector ux. So here, for the maximum height, we are going to use this third formula of kinematic equation. It is the same formula, v square equals u square plus 2ad, but you will use only vertical components of each vector. So vy square, uy square plus, here a is the acceleration, which is vertical acceleration, and in the projectile motion, vertical acceleration is the gravitational or gravity. So here I have plugged in g, and this dy is the vertical distance, which is h. So formula would look like this. Now plug in values. Final vertical velocity is 0 at this point. Initial is 28, we have calculated 2 times. The value of gravity is minus 9.8 meter per second square, and capital S as it is. We will solve this and we will get the value as 40 meter for maximum height. Now we have to find the time of the flight. So what is time of the flight? Time of the flight means the time for which ball remains in the air. So ball is starting from here and goes like this up to the final point. So time taken by ball remain in the air, which is this time, from initial point to the final point, the time taken by ball from initial point to the final point is the time of the flight, and for which we are going to use the second kinematic equation, which is d equals to ut plus half at square. What we have to do here, we will use this formula for vertical components only. Dy is the change in vertical distance, that is delta y. U is the vertical component of u, that is uy, t plus half. In place of a, we plug in g and t square. And now plug in all the things. There is no change in the vertical distance. You might ask why. Let me show you. From initial point to the final point, ball is at some height, or suppose at the zero height at this point, and again at the final position, ball is again at the zero height. 0 minus 0 is 0. So there is no change in vertical distance, right? The initial position and the final position are at the same height. So delta y would be the 0. So no change in the vertical distance, that is 0. Uy is 28, t half, minus 9.8 for gravity, and t square. Solve this equation, you will get 5.71 seconds for time of the flight. So these are the steps to find maximum height and time of the flight. Please keep in mind, you need to use these steps in all the projectile motion problems to solve maximum height and time of the flight. Steps will remain same, even formulas and kinematic equations will remain same. Values might change for every problem. So subscribe and click on the bell icon. Don't forget to share and like with your friends. Thank you. Bye-bye.